By the end of the week, we should have a better idea about whether the Johnson & Johnson COVID-19 vaccine will be put back into circulation or if the pause on these shots will stay in place. But that pause is causing some concern over whether these shots are safe. And one Mississippi doctor was helping to shed some light on the situation. Here's COVID-19 specialist Amanda Decker with the story.
Researchers may be one step closer to finding the link between the Johnson & Johnson COVID-19 vaccine and those potential blood clots. U.S. and European regulators have been poring over data this week and believe an autoimmune response may be to blame for causing the severe reaction. There have been at least six separate reports of women in the U.S. suffering from blood clots after getting the J&J shots that caused federal officials to put a pause on administering that vaccine. But none of those cases were in Mississippi, and so far, the vaccine rollout in the state has been slow but free of any severe problems. And the chances of experiencing a severe reaction like a blood clot from a vaccine, well, are extremely rare.
We've vaccinated over 28,000 at this point and have had essentially zero patients who've had a significant reaction that will require hospitalization or anything of the sort.
4,200 J&J shots had been administered across Mississippi before the pause was put in place last week. But in every documented case of severe reaction, the symptoms appeared within 13 days of getting the shots.
Signs and symptoms to watch for would be a severe headache, severe abdominal or leg pain, and or shortness of breath.
These aren't the typical vaccine side effects people are experiencing, like minor fever, body aches, or headaches. These symptoms are intense and debilitating, and doctors stress they are extremely rare. Although they're worried now that by removing the J&J vaccines from the supply chain, even temporarily, that may have led to more vaccine hesitancy.
Demand for vaccines has decreased drastically over the last 2 weeks, and that is very discouraging and worrying that we will not have enough immunity in the community as we reach the fall and these other variants become more prevalent.
Right now, about 23% of all eligible adults in Mississippi are fully vaccinated, but if we don't reach at least 70% by the end of the summer, we could be wearing masks well into the fall and winter months. I'm COVID-19 specialist Amanda Decker reporting.